Polling has ended now in phase 4 of the elections in India, and there are 3 more phases to go. This phase also saw the conclusion of voting in the southern states, a region that the ruling NDA is hoping to make inroads into. Voting concluded in 9 states and union territories in all, 25 seats in Andhra Pradesh, 17 seats in Telangana. Apart from these southern states, polls also took place in 13 seats in Uttar Pradesh, 11 in Maharashtra, 8 constituencies each in Madhya Pradesh and West Bengal, 5 seats in Bihar, 4 each in Jharkhand and Odisha, and in 1 seat in Jammu and Kashmir. There were minor clashes reported in 2 states. In West Bengal, the supporters of the ruling TMC allegedly pelted stones on the vehicle of the BJP candidate from Bardhaman Durgapur Lok Sabha seat, Dilip Ghosh. In Andhra Pradesh, where the assembly elections and the 4th phase of the Lok Sabha elections took place simultaneously, a minor scuffle broke out after YSRCP candidate for the state assembly elections attacked a voter. This is the first major election in Kashmir since the abrogation of Article 370. Vyond's Idris Lone, who is in Pulwama, sent us this report where he talks about the higher voter turnout.
Srinagar constituency has broken all the previous records of vote percentage. Today we saw a huge number of people coming out of their homes to cast their vote. After the delimitation, Srinagar now consists of 5 districts, which is Shopian, Pulwama, Gandharbal, Badgam and Srinagar. Over 17 lakh voters in the Srinagar constituency, and a huge number of people today voted for the first time in such numbers across the Srinagar constituency. There are 3 main candidates in the fray. One is from the National Conference, Aga Ruhullah, one from People's Democratic Party, Wahid Ahmed Parra, and another one from Apni Party, Ashraf Mir. The National Conference is supported by the India Alliance, mainly Congress, while as PDP is on its own, while as the regional political parties have alleged that the Apni Party candidate is being supported by the BJP, as they have not fielded any candidate in the Kashmir region. With video journalist Firoz Idris Lone for Vyond World is One.
And let's now move on to the state of Maharashtra, where Vyond's Disha Shah has been tracking the high-pitched electoral battle.
2.28 crore voters and 298 candidates in the fray in the 4th phase of Maharashtra. We saw the prominent faces like BJP's Pankaja Munde contesting from the Bid constituency, which always has been a Munde bastion for several years now. And on the other side, we've seen the Shirur constituency under Pune district, where we saw a direct intense fight between NCP versus NCP. In 2019, 7 out of 11 of these seats were won by the ruling BJP. So the BJP is trying all hard to retain the number of seats that they had won last time, and for the opposition they have fielded heavy candidates to ensure that they also have some wins to their side. So this will be a direct and a 3-cornered fight between the NCP, the BJP and the Shiv Sena in the 4th phase of Maharashtra.
And we also have Vyond Siddharth MP summing up the mood on the ground.
In total, there's about 129 seats that have completed polling in the southern part of the country. The south is very crucial because this is a region that is a stronghold of the Congress-led India Alliance. Congress-led alliances in power in 2 states and other states. They're either in the ruling alliance or they're in opposition. The BJP is also looking to make great inroads into southern part of the country. And if the BJP-led NDA wants to bag 400 plus seats in the Lok Sabha, a very, very decisive majority, then the south will play a crucial role.
And with the completion of today's voting, polling has concluded for 381 of the lower houses, total of 543 seats. The next phase of the elections is on the 20th of May, with the results slated to be announced on the 4th of June. To stay up to speed with the latest news, download the Vyond app and subscribe to our YouTube channel.